I am Joachim for Statistics Globe, and in this video I'll explain how to create a contingency table with proportions and percentages in the R programming language. In the video I'm going to show you an example, and this example is based on the example vector that we can create with lines 2 to 3 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you can see at the top right of RStudio that a new vector object appears, which is called values. And we can print these values to the RStudio console by running line 4 of the code. And then you can see that we have created a random vector consisting numeric values. Now let's assume that we want to create a contingency table using the basic installation of the R programming language. Then we can simply apply the table function, as you can see in line 6 of the code. And I'm applying the table function to our vector of values. And then I'm storing the output of this in a new table object, which is called contingency table. So if you run line 6 of the code, you can see that a new table object appears at the top right of RStudio. And we can print this table to the RStudio console by running line 7 of the code. And then you can see at the bottom that we have created a table. And the upper line of this table is showing the values of our vector. And the second line of this table is showing the count of each of these values. So for instance, the value 100 appears 19 times in our vector, and the value 105 appears only twice in our vector. Now let's assume that we want to calculate the proportions of these values in our vector. Then we can apply the prop table function, as you can see in line 9 of the code. And in this line of code, I'm applying this function to our contingency table that we have created before. And then I'm storing the output of this in a new table object, which is called proportion table. So if you run line 9 of the code, you can see that another data object appears at the top right of RStudio, which is called proportion table. And we can print this table to the RStudio console by running line 10 of the code. So after running this line of code, you can see at the bottom in the RStudio console that we have created a proportion table, because this time the values are shown in percentages. So for instance, the value 100 is shown in 19% of the cases in our vector. As you have seen with line 9 and 10 of the code, we have created a table with proportions. So in this case, 0.19. However, if we want to show real percentages, we need to multiply these values by 100. And this is what we are doing in line 12 of the code. So if you run line 12 of the code, a percentage table is created that we can also print to the RStudio console by running line 13 of the code. And now you can see that the value 100 is contained to 19% of the times in our vector. Or for instance, the value 105 is contained in 2% of the times in our vector. Now, in the previous lines of code, we have created a contingency table, a proportion table, and a percentage table. However, if we want to analyze our data, it makes a lot of sense to combine all of these values to one combined table. And we can do that by using the rbind function, as you can see in lines 15 to 17 of the code. And within the rbind function, I'm specifying the names of our contingency table, of our proportion table, and of our percentage table. And then I'm storing the output of this in a new table object, which is called table all. So if you run lines 15 to 17 of the code, you can see at the top right of RStudio that we have created a new data object, which is called table all. And we can print this table to the RStudio console by running line 18 of the code. And then you can see that we have created a new table, which is consisting of three rows, whereby the first row is showing the contingencies, the second row is showing the proportions, and the third row is showing the percentages of the values in our vector. So in this video, I have explained how to extend a contingency table by proportions and percentages. However, in case you want to learn more on this topic, you could check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on my homepage, I have recently published a tutorial in which I'm explaining the content of this video in some more detail, and I will put a link to this tutorial into the description of the video. Furthermore, if you have liked this video, I would be very happy if you leave me some positive feedback in the comments. And make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notifications in future when I'm releasing new videos to the channel. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot. See you next time. Bye bye.